A nice way to end the year. You must be delighted with that result.
I'm buzzing for the boys' derby game, you know. And listen, the fans turned up in their numbers today. It was a fantastic support, and they were in here at 1:45 singing songs and being loud and jovial. And it sounds like they've had a good Christmas. I hope maybe we've added to that, just to continue that enjoyment. So I'm delighted. Listen, there was not a lot in the game today. Stenhouse Muir were always a threat, but we've found a way. We've dug deep, some heroic defending, some heroic running against the ball, people shifting across the park, really doing the stuff that sometimes goes unnoticed. Shape was terrific, and a clinical couple of goals, you know, really clinical, so delighted with it.
She's had a lot of the ball, a lot of corners, and yet their goalkeeper was named their man of the match.
I think they had a lot of possessionally and zonally. They were maybe more dominant than what we were on the day. I thought we had the better chances in the game. You know, I thought Darrell could have scored in the first half, and we had other bits and pieces. But overall, you know, just absolutely delighted. I said to you last week, you know, two big games are coming up. I mean, it was really two must wins. You don't want to boil your season down to two games, but it's important now that we do start to turn in these fine margins for draws and losses into draws for, obviously, for us, point each, and wins for us. You know, that's important. Today, we might have conceded a goal before, one each, but we've went and dug one out in a terrific finish, and I'm delighted for David.
Yeah, the starting lineup maybe raised a few eyebrows, but it obviously worked for you.
Well, you know, we looked at it last week, and maybe it was a bit unfair in putting Josh in so early, you know, because he did look a wee bit flat for me. And I even think today, when he comes on, he looks a lot fresher. Maybe that full fitness just isn't quite there yet. Jamesy, you know, I spoke to Cammy Thompson. For me, Jamesy right now is just that wee bit ahead defensively than Cammy. But Cammy's a development, you know, he's going to be a terrific and such an important player for us that I can't play that down enough. But Cammy's actually, he's got a wee injury, so that's why he wasn't involved today. And Danny, you know, Danny's played a lot of football. Danny's played every minute apart from the half-time at Cove game where he came off.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's a wee element there of protecting him a wee bit and, you know, letting him maybe recharge the batteries a wee bit, which has opened the door for Dom and Div, who've had their spell on the bench, let it be said. So they've been patient. They've been angry and frustrated. So, but they've went and answered it, you know, and the fans will be delighted. And at the end of the day, I don't think the fans care who the manager is. I don't think they care who the players are. The team's winning, that's what they want, so I'm delighted to deliver that today, but I know there's a long way to go.
Max Wright's not had a lot of game time, but he was excellent today.
Aye, you know, listen, Max has been sort of a victim of people not playing badly, but no, maybe doing enough, you know, and there's been a few players like that, players have just been doing enough, but, you know, after last week, I just felt, you know, now's the time to change certain things, and I thought Max has been, he's been such a good professional. He's never given me a headache. He's asked the questions about what he can do. He's moaned at the right times. He's banged on the door at the right times, you know, but what he's never done is throwing the toys out the pram. He's never been that guy. He's worked incredibly hard, and I think today, you know, even a wee bit of match sharpness, he could have had an even better game, but he was outstanding, as were a lot of them, and I'm delighted for him, you know, I'm delighted for the team, to be honest, so just happy.
Were you worried at 1-0 that Steny might, after losing a late goal last week, that Steny might nick something?
Aye, I think we looked at it, you know, we put Danny on there, we changed the shape a wee bit, and to be honest, I thought it worked. I thought we got that one right. I thought, I don't know, was it last week or the week before, but you know, we changed the shape and it didn't quite work, and Martin and I will always hold our hands up for things like that, but I thought today we got one right for a change, and when we went, you know, to the sort of two sitting with Danny and Max Wade, I thought it just gives a better balance and it steadied the ship. And by the time Big Kyle came on, you know, I felt quite comfortable. You know, I did. I felt with a good bit of experience on the park at the end of the game, and it showed. We managed the game very well. You know, Max getting into the corner, James Craney, Kevin Nicol, these are guys, Darrell Duffy, you know, about, and they did it well. They did it well.
Yeah, I think from 90 minutes onwards, the game was in their half completely.
You know, and that's something maybe we've been guilty in the past. I've maybe been a wee bit naive. Hannon last year springs to mind, 2-1. You know, and there's been other instances, you know, so, but aye, listen, absolutely delighted with the win. I'm delighted for the boys, and it sets us up nicely for a big game next week, you know, and it's going to be difficult. The surface, as we all know, is not going to be ideal, but it's the same for both teams, and it's important that, you know, we go there with a positive frame of mind, another away victory, which you've kindly pointed out wasn't happening enough, and we've got a chance again to add to that.
Yeah, halfway through the season now, I think you're confident you can really push on in the second half.
Yes, I'm confident. I've never lost belief in the team, and I think the way they've turned up week in, week out, and consistently, the performance levels have been pretty good all in all, you know. And I've got my criticisms, you know, myself first and foremost. We've not been clinical enough. I think we've put that to bed. I think we're slowly but surely getting the goal tally up. The defensive unit, if you like, the full team has never been in question. They're a hard team to beat. I'm sure Dick Campbell might disagree, but. No, I'm delighted. I'm happy where we're at the minute, just in terms of the performance levels. In the league, the points tally, it's no good enough. It's no good enough, but simply must get better. And between now, the challenge for us, between now and May, the next 18 games, is to be one of the best teams in this league, and that is exactly what I'm going to try and achieve.
Final one, Kevin, any update on bringing in a goalkeeper, or will young JB on the bench again next week?
Well, you know, obviously the transfer window's going to open between now and then, and it's something we'll look at. What we can do, Jay's Stonelaw, as Jay's parent club, have been absolutely magnificent. You know, they've allowed us, Billy there has allowed us to put Jay on the bench, and, you know, so kudos to them, and we'll try and, you know, sort them out one way or another with something as a thank you. It's not a long-term fix. So, you know, we've been working in the background, and it's nice that Cammy's come in at such a high level, because it certainly eases that worry a wee bit, you know. But he's been that way since pre-season. He ran Blair so close, you know. He was outstanding pre-season games in the Betfred Cup, and as I say, hopefully, you know, if he can maintain that, then we're not going to have a problem.
And no other arrivals or departures imminent?
Well, I think there's going to be some boys here frustrated at lack of game time. And that's certainly something we'll approach with them. You know, we've already had sort of preliminary discussions with some boys about, you know, that game time and how we go about getting them, whether it be, you know, here or elsewhere, or the challenge maybe over the next 4 weeks to get themselves in the team. But we'll look at it. We've got the luxury of having that depth and quality in the squad, and, you know, if the right players become available, we'll certainly be interested, but they've got to be right. They've got to be right now. We've got to make sure that the next player that walks in here is improving this 11 and not just a squad player. It's going to be hard to find at this juncture, but we've been scratching the surface behind the scenes, and I'll tirelessly sort of look at that as long and hard as possible.